Hello and welcome back. In this video, I want to show you how you can allow your users to submit WooCommerce products from the front end using Frontend Admin Pro. As an example, we'll be using this car listings website. And if you come here and click on Add Car Listing, you'll be taken to a form where you can submit your car listing. So for example, let's say the car will be, something like Emerald Mirage. That's from ChatGPT, by the way. And let's just paste in this description that I got from ChatGPT. It's a cool app. And let's just use that as a short description of the product. And the price that ChatGPT suggested is $320,000. Looks like I'm in the wrong business. Let's toggle Manage Stock, and we'll add 3 to the stock. We have currently 3 in stock. Don't allow back orders, and let's add the image. Submit. Our product has been submitted, and we can see our car here in the list of cars. All right, so in order to set this up, the first thing I'm going to need to do is log in as an administrator. All right, so I'm signed in now as an administrator. As you can see, I set up a page that's built with Elementor, and it is empty. So I'm going to go ahead and set up the form that's going to allow your users to add products from the front end. So all you have to do is type in your widgets search bar, add product. And that's going to give you a few options. You want the add product form, and just drag that in. Voila! You now have a fully functioning add product form on your website. Now, this has the basic fields. You're probably going to add some fields, remove some fields based on your needs. So for example, I'm going to want to add a short description field as well as the description field. So in order to do that, you can just go ahead and duplicate the description field and change the type to short description. And also the label, change that to short description. And now it's a short description field. You're probably going to want to add a sale price. So go ahead and duplicate the price field and do the same thing. Change the type to sale price. As the label, you'll want to call it sale price. That's it. Now you have a price field and a sale price field. In the form that we submitted, there was an option to manage the stock. So you're going to want to go ahead and add that field to manage the stock. That's under the product inventory, under manage stock. And that's going to give the user a toggle to turn the manage stock option on and off. Yeah, and we're probably going to want to add a stock quantity field as well. For now, you're going to want to go ahead and click publish and preview changes. And everything looks good. We have the title field, the description field, the short description field, the price field and sale price fields. And we have an image field and the manage stock option, which we can toggle on and off. And if we turn it on, we can see the stock options. And we have the submit button. So we have everything we need. Last thing we need to configure is the permissions. You can see this message here. What this message is saying is that by default, only administrators can see the form, and only administrators can see this message. And in order to configure the permissions, you're going to have to jump back into your form and scroll down. Go into the content tab and scroll down to where it says permissions. Open that up. And here you can add any number of rules which will determine who can see this form. So click on add item. Let's give this a name, say all merchants. And for the sake of this tutorial, merchants are users with the author role. And so go ahead and under select by role, you're going to want to choose authors. And so what this means is that the form is going to check if the current user is an administrator or an author. And if they are, they'll be able to see this form and submit products. There's other options here, like select by capabilities. So WooCommerce and WordPress have all these capabilities that different user roles have. And so you can limit the visibility of the form based on these specific capabilities. But for the sake of this tutorial, we're just going to use the author role. Save your changes. One more thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and in actions, we're going to want to change the redirect of the form. So by default, the form is just going to reload the page. We're going to want to change this to custom URL because we're going to want to take the user back to the list of cars. And so under the URL, go ahead and paste your URL. So here I pasted the URL of the car listings page. And we're going to want to show a success message. And for error, we're going to want to show this error message. Save your changes. Let's see how it looks on the front end. Great. Now we don't have that message anymore. Now administrators and authors will be able to see the form on the front end and submit products. And so now all that's left to do is to bring users to this page. So go ahead and copy the URL and go into your car listings page and click Edit with Elementor. Add a button widget. Let's center it right in the middle. And go back to the content tab. Change the label to add your car listing. Paste your URL. And publish. Great. Let's give it one more test. Let's go back to our incognito tab where we're logged in as an author, and we're gonna go to the car listings, click on add car listing, go ahead and add your title and your AI generated description, AI generated short description, AI suggested price, AI suggested sale price, and go ahead and add an image. Yeah, and just go ahead and toggle on manage stock. Let's put in a stock quantity and submit. And as you can see, our product has been submitted successfully. And so that's it. Now you know how to use the Add Product Form widget for Elementor and Frontend Admin Pro. This is perfect for user-generated content like car listings and other product listings. Thank you for joining us. Please subscribe to our channel and give us a huge like.